your WLKY weather with Chief Meteorologist Jay Cardoso.
All right, no doubt waking up on this Tuesday morning to lots of heavy rainfall, even some hail in a few spots, very, very vivid lightning, loud thunder, and anywhere from 1 to 3, locally 4 inches of rainfall across Jefferson County. But you could see by midday into the afternoon, the storms departed off to the east. Skies became partly sunny. Even right now, things are much quieter. Take a look at the radar scope. As you can see, zoomed in tight around Jefferson County, surrounding regions. There's a sight for sore eyes. Now, we needed the water. Things were getting kind of dry out there after this last long, hot holiday weekend. But boy, 4 inches of rainfall like that. I don't know if anybody needs that much water in that short a period of time, but nonetheless, we have a clean sweep right now. As we pull out, you can see another band of showers running from Crawford County through Perry County and points off to the south, western Breckinridge County. A bigger storm firing up in southern Ohio County. That is moving southeast and will miss the viewing area. And this little batch of shower activity, as it moves eastward, is really losing its punch, will likely fall apart in relatively short order. Bottom line, best chances for a few widely scattered showers, maybe rumbles of thunder, west and southwest of the I-65 corridor as we progress throughout the evening hours. And really, that should be just about it. That's the good news. Right now, partly to mostly cloudy skies in town. Temperatures are warm, low and middle 80s out there. Humidity 54% with a northwest breeze, right around 6 miles per hour. Weather in motion the last couple of hours, showing that latest band of showers and storms starting to fizzle out, re-intensify farther southwest into sections of Tennessee. But the big action throughout the course of the day has been off to the east and northeast of us as far as severe weather is concerned. They've really gotten hit hard, especially in the mid-Atlantic, up into sections of New England. That's where showers and storms have been quite prevalent. They've been fast movers as far as producing wind, hail, even a few isolated tornadoes. And there's still all sorts of severe thunderstorm watches and tornado watches in effect in the northeast even right now. Everything being kicked off by a very soupy air mass, lots of moisture funneling northward from the Gulf of Mexico, some jet stream energy, and that cold front. The front is just west of Louisville. It's kind of pivoting through as we speak. Drier air is behind it. And as the night wears on, everybody will get into that drier air mass. Bottom line, conditions improve everywhere overnight tonight, and tomorrow looks to be a delightful day. Let's start off tomorrow morning. Lots of sunshine, quiet conditions as high pressure builds in on your Wednesday morning. Shifting into the afternoon, no problems at all. It's going to be a great day tomorrow with mostly sunny skies, less humid conditions, still warm, but pleasantly warm. High temperatures in your hometown, lower 80s. In southern portions of Indiana, with low to middle 80s from about the Ohio River and points off to the south. So here's the forecast. Next few hours, a few showers, mainly west and southwest of Louisville. Those should be diminishing as we slowly drop through the 70s. By 10 o'clock tonight, partly cloudy and pleasant in 74. We'll wake up to 66 in the morning. Keep in mind there could be some patchy fog, especially those areas that saw the heavy rainfall earlier, like the metro. 79 midday tomorrow, mostly sunny conditions. The afternoon high in your 7-day looks great, 85 degrees. Looking ahead, it looks unsettled again, however, as we shift into Thursday, especially late Thursday and Thursday night. And Vicky, Rick, even some of those storms could be strong to severe. We'll watch that situation close. Behind that front, look at that air. Upper 60s Friday, wow. 77 Saturday, and then we climb back into the 80s with a renewed chance for a few storms by Sunday night. So, you know, typical summer weather the last week or so, again later on this week, but there's a couple of days coming up that it's going to be quite cool out there at the end of this week.
Different than what we're used to.
Ups and downs in the Ohio Valley.
It is.
Not expected.
Thanks a lot, Jay.